Oh my god, that's night and day better, but it's loud as hell for me. There we go. Okay. Yeah, my audio, it should be fine. It might be a tiny bit quiet, but I think it should be fine. Room 5, we're gonna do MOE without a doubt. I'm not sure if I'm gonna have to bring in more to that, like, APOC dorm, etc., but, yeah, and actually, before I get started with the planning here, just in case anybody missed it, I want to show you guys my defense here. So, to start off, I've got, for pressure points, I've got Darkhold with Shang-Chi. Shang-Chi is just an extra toon that I have lying around, who's a raider, and he's a raider who goes quickly. So I'm looking to get that minor defense down out there early, and then I've got two raiders and two strikers to capitalize on, and I'm hoping Shang-Chi adds some kind of value here. Otherwise, he's just on the bench, so like it doesn't matter if he's a bit of a waste. Room 2, we've got Bifrost. I've been trying to tell people, and nobody is listening. And people are learning for themselves now. Bifrost is the option. Whether you want to put them on offense or defense is your choice. But Bifrost is the number one team with zero speculation. It's Bifrost. Not Deathseed, not Rebirth. As the Apex team. You can put whatever you want in there, but people got to stop arguing over stupid shit as if Rebirth and Deathseed can keep up with Bifrost. Room 3 here, I've put in Nowhere with Kestrel. So my Nowhere is 300,000 power bigger than my Infinity Watch, so that's why I'm doing them over Infinity Watch. And my theory is that, so with Cosmic Heroes, on turn gate deflect, and when attacked, apply defense down to the attacker. So I'm going to have Kestrel, who can benefit off of those defense downs. She is a Cosmic Hero. Cosmo is useless on this team, and my lowest built character because of Astral Energy unique crunches. So I think this should hold up well. I don't think it'll get me any wins, maybe one or two. But I think it's going to pull some efficiency harder than people think. Room 4, I've got Rebirth, because they always have offense up. Like, they pretty much just always have offense up. Cap gets hit, offense up. On Cap Taunt, offense up. On Taunt, offense up. I was making sure I had that right there. So Rebirth is good here. There's a lot of teams you could use here, though. A lot of people are using War Dog so far, as I'm seeing, like my opponent. I'm definitely going to stick with Rebirth, likely for the season, I think. We'll have to see how it goes. And Room 5, we've got Mutant Spiders. So, I am rocking Phoenix Jubilee, Dazzler, Gambit, Rogue. A lot of people are saying the Phoenix Jubilee health bonus isn't useful and you could just Eternals APOC it. Okay, well, my old meta tunes just pulled APOC Eternals. Unlimited X-Men before was only pulling Walking Hate. That's nothing. Now it can pull APOC Eternals. So everyone here is going to get plus 60% max health. The buffs... Here, I'm going to go into the kits, actually. So, you also get... I'm going to be building Phoenix, because I have her 7 red. So, ignore the fact that she's not built. It's coming. Plus 30% damage as well to all allies on that field. Let's go over to Jubilee here. When any ally drops below 50% health... Oh, that's all for Beast, so ignore that. On Death, fill all allies' speed bar by 25%. On this character's and each character's turn, apply assist now to self or any ally on the field. So you're getting assist now all the time. And then this special. So gain assist at 50% damage from all Astonishing X-Men allies. That's going to be all allies are assisting. So you're getting Rogue, Gambit, you're getting a blind from Jubilee. You're getting everything in this attack. And I don't think people have really thought about how useful this attack is going to be. I am going to build Phoenix, but I'm not going to build Jubilee for that room. Whoops. Double click in here. And then... So that's my room 5. Phoenix is going to be double that power by the end of the week. And then for the building momentum room, because it's bugged, this is a waste. Like, Gamma is terrible right now because it's bugged. When it's not bugged, I have a theory that they're going to be absolutely insane, because you're going to have Red Hulk special all the time. You're going to have the Hulk taunt and heal all the time, and mine's a healer, so he always pretty much full heals. You're going to have She-Hulk rewind every other turn. You're going to have A-bomb defense and offense down. I believe it's every other turn. And then you're going to have A-bomb copying all positive effects or full healing and dealing 35% damage as well. So I think once this room goes to its intended purpose, I think this will be good. And it's just because I don't want Gamma on offense. I want them on D as an efficiency drain. And people are saying, well, you can New Warriors it. Okay, I've just pulled the top Crucible team in the game for Gamma, just straight Gamma. So that's my defense here. I'm going to continue with my planning here, and then we'll get this these attacks going. That was a little bit loud for me. Turn that down. Okay. So I've got MOE accounted for in room 5. Am I going to New Warriors room 6? Let's see what we got to work with here. I do have Eternals. Okay, so I've got... Because there is a viewer here, I don't know if you're actually watching or not, but I'll scroll through so you can see what I'm going rocking with. Here's one. Death Seed in room 2. That'll take out Astonishing X-Men, no problem. With incredible efficiency. Is War Dogs versus War Dogs efficient? Because my War Dogs is bigger by 200,000 power. I might try that. Yeah, it's a War Dogs, not Wakandan. I might try that just for shits and giggles here. War Dogs. Okay. What am I going to use for Eternals? I'm thinking... So I can APOC Eternals room 1. Because that's an Infinity Watch that's going to be on crack. Because they're getting 200% damage at all times. And then for 3 against their Eternals with Emma, so I can't outspeed them. I think it's hiding down here. We can do Tangled, so we can do not Noir, so Tangled with Weaver in 2099. Fury. I still have Infinity Watch too as a cleanup team and YA if I need it against that War Dogs room. And I don't think I bring Doom against room 3 against Eternals. I don't think that would be smart. So what else am I going to stick in there? Am I just going to do Undying? Tangled plus Fury plus Undying, I guess. It's not exactly the best comp, and that guarantees that Icarus gets a double tap is my issue with Zombie Iron Man and Hela. Well, I have Dorm, so scratch out Undying. I'll do Dorm plus whatever filler character I can find. I'm sure I'll have someone. All right, I'm gonna start with the big boy room here, room 5, and I'm gonna pray straight MOE beats it. I'm really doubtful though. This new season is going to be a little rough at first to start. Let's see what works and what doesn't work. I might have to put Dorm in here for Absorbing Man, but I'm going to try and save Dorm. All right. This usually lands. Oh, it didn't land everything though. That almost always lands. That's unfortunate. Kang, I'm really gonna have to rely on you here, bud. I like that this is in a room where they get no buffs. Yeah, definitely not special, because I can't land anything. Just get that straight turn meter rewind. I don't know if attacking Apocalypse to turn meter rewind him is the right move. I think it is, but I might be completely wrong here. Speed us up. Want that immunity. She's got safeguard immunity now, so if Apocalypse pops off, Titania is slightly safe. Yeah, Absorbing Man fucking sucks. I'm probably gonna have to bring Dorm in place of him. I don't know if this is gonna be a win. It might be too much of a punch up too. And with Absorbing Man dying, well, I guess I just cleared all those negative effects. I was gonna say I didn't get to clear shit, but okay, good stuff. This is almost getting into cleanup territory where I could keep it and clean it. It's not looking good. Let's bring in Dorm. Well, I plan to use Tangled in 3, but I'm not paying attention. I don't have a good Spider-Verse team, though, is the issue. I was gonna say, do I use a Spider-Verse comp here? Like, what I could do is some Weaver. Here, let's do this. Make life a lot easier. Okay. Weaver, 2099. I don't think this will work. Ghost Spider, Scarlet Spider. Like, that's just too weak. Apoc's just gonna rip him apart. I don't think that's doable whatsoever. If this doesn't work, I'm gonna skip this team, I believe. Yeah, if this doesn't work, I'll leave it for now and I'll hit New Warriors into room 6 and we'll go from there. New Warriors obviously wouldn't beat this, right? I don't believe they would. Okay, land this time. Nope, didn't land shit. I didn't land the ability block on her, so now I'm turning to rewinding her instead of Apoc, which might be even worse. But last time, rewinding Apoc didn't do shit for me either, so. Alright, land the stun. Come on, Moonstone. Land the stun! Good shit. I should have done the special to get the trauma because of Apocalypse. Yeah, I'm gonna special here too instead of basicing on Apoc. I don't think it's gonna matter, and I haven't hit Apoc yet, so why would I do that and speed him up? Give me the death proof. And then Ultron should be able to take out MLF. Oh, offense down? Shit. I think we should still be okay. Okay, it doesn't matter if we speed him up now. He's full turn bar. This is looking better. I have offense down. If I didn't have offense down, I would probably hit that into the APOC. There is a chance that that kills APOC. Yeah, like, what was that? Like 1.9 million damage with offense down and offense up. So just straight, I don't know how to word it. Medium, regular damage. Oh my god. I'm losing it. Okay, turn meter, either one of them works for Strange Heartless or Apoc, so I can't complain about either of them there. Oh, this looks like shit still. Like, it looks good, but it's not going to in a second. Oh, we're so close to taking him out. Oh, why did he lose all that turn meter? I'll take that. Thank you, Strange Heartless. Alright, well, we got through it. MOE will work against Darkhold APOC, MOE Dorm. And a roughly 300k poncho. So that's good. Yeah, I was thinking about using Tangled Web here. But I just don't think it's gonna work. No, I think this is my best option. I really gotta think about this now. Oh my god. I like it. Like, it's difficult. There's a chance that I can make myself look absolutely stupid again. Let's hope that this is just over after five turns here. I'm not gonna get another turn before she goes, so put that striker attack into her. Really? I didn't kill her? Come on, Dagger, what's wrong with you? Dagger, you weak ass bitch. What are you doing? Could ult, but this will take out both of them, so. I gotta learn how to do all the mods and stuff, like redeeming points and whatnot. I don't know how to do that. I'm so new to Twitch, it's ridiculous. Like, I just started using it in terms of watching people on Twitch a few weeks ago. I was always a YouTube guy. We'll get Deathseed Astonishing X-Men out of the way, because that one's nice, quick, and easy. Until Astonishing X-Men surprises me and wrecks my booty. But we've got new Metamutant against old Metamutant, so now all I'm thinking about is Metamucil when I say Metamutant, and suddenly I need more dietary fiber. And match is over. Oh, no, it's not? Shit, I thought he would do more damage. I played myself. gotta get some more coffee here. I should ult of it because that's the better move, but I just want to summon in Cosmic Crucible and make this interesting. I got a beast on my team now. This is sick. None of these are unavoidable, right? Yeah, okay. I'll do this one. Get all those buffs, even though I won't need them for any particular reason. This attack cannot miss. Well, it's gonna get dodge. Oh, cannot miss affects dodge. Okay. Okay. Well, shit. I thought dodge would trump a cannot miss. Silly me. Alright, what do we get next? We can do War Dogs into War Dogs. I'm trying to save some of those heavy hitters for the end there. I don't see why this would go wrong minus just turn meter, but let's go in there, fuck around, and find out. I could so do War Dogs against Infinity Watch. It's probably too late now, because I'm not just going to back out if I don't win this, but... Or, if I win this. But War Dogs against Infinity Watch in room 1. I've got 2 strikers? 3 strikers? 3 strikers. Sorry, I'm just thinking who to take the speed up from. And with that 200% damage buff, they would just all go... well before Infinity Watch, and then it's match over, right? I would assume. We'll be weird and do the special to make sure we kill Black Panther. There weren't really positive effects to take regardless. But that's not gonna chain through stealth. Sad. Could have taken out Okoye. Most deflex kept her alive. Doesn't matter though. That's not gonna kill her. Almost, but not quite. Thought about just killing the Shuri, but I didn't need to. Why you gotta be a bitch like that, Nakia? Why you gotta hit me like that? It's funny. My gaming friend just sent me a gaming meme. Where it's... I play with a guy and a girl who are together, like their boyfriend and girlfriend. And it is like, you tell your girlfriend you're gonna hop online for only a few with the boys, and it's telling her, I'm gonna hop online for a few, and then it turns into like an old age, like grandpa, basically intending that they've been on for their entire life. Sounds stupid when I explain it, but it was funny. Let's make sure, before I go Apoc Eternals Doom into one, let's make sure that we can take this with Tangled. So, Apoc Eternals should be fine in room 1. I don't need Doom for room 1. Doom's not amazing against Eternals, but sadly it's kind of what I'm getting. Oh, I have Eternals. Oh yeah, that's going in room 1. We're gonna do Fury. We're not going to do Hela, because that guarantees a double tap. Guaranteed double tap against me. I don't think there's going to be anything useful here for myself. Like, we could almost sack it, but, like, we don't play Crucible trying to sack things on the first try, because how are you going to get efficiency if you're purposely sacking? Alright, we might... Are we gonna outspeed them? I didn't even think about this. Well, like, I thought about it, but, like, I didn't realize I might outspeed them here. Yeah, Weaver's gonna get to go first. Bada bing, bada boom! 1 million damage from that Skirmisher Weaver? That's sick. That was so close to getting the kill. So close. Just in case. Could have ability blocked Cersei, but just in case. Alright, that went swimmingly. I was completely wrong about the speed bar, and I went first, and that changes literally everything. I thought I was gonna get hit right off the bat. Damn, are we gonna full clear day one? I'm happy about that. Main reason I'm full clearing though is because they put Astonishing X-Men in the raid room. Like, tomorrow, I guarantee you, it's Bifrost or Rebirth and they're gonna be big. Guaranteed. I feel bad for this guy going against my 1 million Bifrost. I cannot wait to look at what they did. I cannot wait. Icarus. Apoc. Actually, let's at least like set this up for some kind of success and have them spread out, even though I don't think it's gonna matter, but Cersei. And we'll do Undying here. Yeah. Infinity Watch, please don't hurt me like I know you can. I know you're insane in this room right now. Don't hurt me. 200% damage at all times from a team built on having four strikers. I'm scared. I am scared. A little bit. Until Icarus just pops off and kills them all. How much damage is this gonna do? No! What the fuck is that? I can't even double tap now. It's over. She killed Apoc. Oh my god, I'm making that like a YouTube short or something. What the fuck? We're bringing in some speed manipulation.
Okay.
What the fuck, man? Oh my god. I would assume Emma's enough. Do I bring in Cable because efficiency is not gonna matter? Holy fuck. Like my Cable's really weak. Well, I can do Hela. Let's do Hela still. Wow. Wow. Gamora just fucked me. Bad. Oh my god, that is insane. That is insane. I'm scared, man. Am I gonna get tripped up on an Infinity Watch here? Okay. Okay, come on. Just nail him. Even if you don't get the double tap. Okay, got the double tap. Why no double tap? Fuck this game. So dumb. So dumb. Double tap. Where the fuck is it? If I don't clear this because of this fucking garbage, I swear to God I'm gonna be so mad at this game. It doesn't make any sense that it didn't double tap. That's so frustrating when things completely out of your control make you lose. Oh, it's raining. Fuck off, Gamora. Don't touch me, Gamora. Stay dead. Fuck you. He probably had the same issue with my Infinity Watch. Oh, that was so fucking rude, man. Fuck this game. Did I win at least? Yeah! Yeah! Let's see how bad of a time Dashing Pumbaa had. I didn't do my usual Crucible stuff. Okay, guys, today we're against Dashing Pumbaa. Dashing Pumbaa is 37 million TCP. I myself here am sitting at a measly 33 million TCP. I've completely forgotten how to stream and how to record videos. So that's the intro to the video. Merry Christmas. You're getting it, what are we at here? 20 minutes in? Professional quality stream. Now without further ado, let's look at how they messed up here. Okay, so stage one, Dorm Tangled Fury Nova against Darkhold with Shang-Chi. Okay. They actually cleared my Bifrost. Good shit. Good job. Because that's not an easy matchup. So you watched some videos and you learned what to do. Good stuff. So new warriors failed against Bifrost. Especially in a punch-up. That's for damn sure. They brought in Bifrost. Failed. It's just too small. And that's a coin flip regardless. And then Death Seed worked against it. Likely because my Sylvie's low. I just got her. That's going to change. This team is going to be sitting at about 1.1 mil when I'm done with her. Maybe a bit more. MOE into my nowhere. So, my Cosmic Hero Room, that most people would think is a nothing, is pulling MOE. So, the goal isn't always to win. The goal is to drain your opponent's offense in terms of efficiency building. When you pull certain things to certain places, they cannot use it in other places, and it benefits you. And a lot of people don't think about it like that. So I'm really happy with this. I am incredibly happy with this. And I think this room is a sleeper room. Having Kestrel with the constant defense downs that the room gives, and she gets the room buff, I think it's a no-brainer. Next up, they did Gamma into Rebirth Quicksilver. Damn. I really wish that had worked. I bet you it would have won if they didn't have that massive Red Hulk. That boy is huge. Huge Red Hulk. And we've got Unlimited X-Men into my X-Men team. That's fine because it's a punch down. I'm missing a T4 on Phoenix. I'm going to be building them a bit bigger. And once I put T4s on Phoenix, they're going to have more synergy. So it's at least going to be a better efficiency drain. And then lastly here, they tried New Warriors against my Gamma and they lost because it was a big punch up. And then they hit it with the Weapon X. Okay. Well, it was a punch up today, guys. We got the win. On day one of Broken Crucible, Let's hope it still counts towards the standings. And I'm excited for round two. I am personally not going to change up my defense. I'm not going to change up my defense to fit the bugged rooms. I don't want to be that guy. If I take an L from it, I take an L from it. I'm thinking of putting Infinity Watch in room one, though, and having more to work with on offense. Yeah, I need more on offense currently, it seemed. Because that's not... This guy today is not the strongest room that I'm going to go against. That's for damn sure. 100%, I'm going to have much stronger, likely, in this Crucible tournament. So... So we're going to do that, and then I think it's well worth it to change Moondragon into a striker here. Pretty sure Moondragon's supposed to be a striker regardless, and I just wasn't overly competitive about this game when Infinity Watch was out, so I didn't put the right ISO. Okay. So that looks good there. Oh, I need big boy APOC, man. I'm getting there. I need this on Dazzler. I need ISO 8 and ISO 8 tier 2 level 5 as well, but that'll come once I do the unlimited X-Men part of it. And then I'm just building Death Seed and I'm done. The bad news is I have, okay, so Magneto's gear tier 17. So what I'm sitting at here is this, is the bad news. That's how far away I am, in terms of gear and not ISO 8. And I have a severe crunch on Astral Energy. Like, I need it for Psylocke. I then need it for APOC for DD6. And I also am trying to build my Nowhere really big, but I think I'm going to have to just suck it up and not build Cosmo any higher, because same as well there. But we'll see. While I'm here, I am going to buff the ISO, because I'm using Nowhere in War, Cosmic Crucible, and for the next Legendary event, so... Let's get all of them to ISO 4. Okay. Alright, well, good start. I'm just gonna do an arena attack while I'm on stream here. Step that I take is enough. That was fun though. Playing that Crucible, wow, that was fun. Why don't people know how to set up their defense? You're allowing me to turn me to rewind all three of those characters because of your placement. I now have a vulnerable on, what's her face? Morgan Le Fay. So now I can ability block into Morgan Le Fay with a vulnerable hit. You're silly. That should take him. Oh, fuck off. Yeah, I gotta put it on APOC. I was gonna say there's a chance... I think Rogue might go before Red Hulk here. Depends on how much the charges help the speed. I'm... Oh, you fucking cunt. Jesus Christ. Come on. That's okay. Just got my hopes up is all, and then I got shit on. Mess him up, Red Hulk. Mess him up. Give it to him. Ah, you didn't give it to him. Kind of. Okay, I believe that's everything that I need to do for today. What am I at? Skill or bio boss? Oh, bio boss is done. Okay. By myself. Need that. I want to build dorm more. I have not been low in these materials here in a long time. This arcane powder being a crunch for me just came out of nowhere. Yeah, that's it for video. I really hope you enjoyed it. It's just a quick stream today. I was just getting my crucible in here. I do believe I'm going to do a longer one tomorrow. I really appreciate the support to anybody who watches this and enjoys it. I will be releasing content and streaming content about 5 days a week, as consistently as I can. But other than that, I'm out of here, and you have a good rest of your day, and keep on gaming.